report chart, and this is your Marijuana Money Minute. Next week, we are super excited because Green Market Report is having their first summit in Los Angeles. We're going to be doing a deep dive on the topic of cannabis branding. The number one selling product in California, Plus Products, is going to be talking with CNBC's Jane Wells. We're super excited to have the singer Melissa Etheridge talking about Etheridge Farms. On day two, we have Athletes for Care, who's going to be bringing several professional athletes who have started their own cannabis companies. You can get your tickets at www.greenmarketsummit.com. You don't want to miss this. Okay, on to the news. Markets were closed on Monday to observe the Labor Day holiday, so we had a shortened week. Aurora Cannabis sold off its remaining shares in the Green Organic Dutchman, giving the company roughly $86 million. Aurora had a 50% internal rate of return for this investment. Now, it no longer owns any shares of TGOD, but they still have over 16 million warrants to purchase more shares. TGOD also said this week that it received approval from Health Canada to expand operations in its new greenhouse in Hamilton, Ontario. Medicine Man Technologies had a very busy week this week for acquisitions. The company's going to acquire Colorado Harvest Company, which has two dispensaries in Denver and one in nearby Aurora. They're paying $4 million in cash and $8.5 million in company stock. Then they also announced that they were buying four additional dispensaries in Colorado for $36 million. Still not done. They said they would buy five dispensaries operating under the name Starbuds in Colorado. They're going to pay $31 million for the group. Diego Panzer bought a dispensary in Denver. Now, they didn't say how much they were paying, but they did say that the dispensary did over $8 million in sales last year. Grow Generation picked up Grand Rapids Hydroponics that's located in Michigan. They now have four locations in that state. And finally, WeedMD did a bought deal for 10,000 convertible debentures, netting the company $10 million. And that's it for this week. I'm Deborah Borchardt reporting for the Green Market Report from Times Square.